Hello and welcome to the Flash Flick Show. In this segment, we look at reviews, news, updates of everything related to movies, books and shows. Let's get started. Firstly, I want to talk about an Amazon original show that I watched. It's a superhero animated show that's called... So this show, Invincible, has one season as 8 episodes in it with around 45 to 50 minutes per episode, and I absolutely loved the show. I thought this was just a great superhero show. And looking at the premise, I mean, it's animated, it's a superhero show. You might expect it to be for kids, like something like Teen Titans, but this one is not. It is very mature, adult, and has extreme violence. Emphasis on the word extreme, because it really is hyper violent in some places, but that never feels unnecessary because it uses violence to bring home the point it's trying to make. It looks at superheroes from a very different perspective than most of your other shows and movies that are based off on the superhero genre, and I thought that was just so fresh and unique. It's just executed in a way that just feels slightly more grounded, as in what would actually happen if superheroes existed all around, which is a weird thing to say for a cartoon, but believe me, it does have some brutal, realistic, grounded moments in it. Every single character is actually very well written. There's amazing amount of character depth, and one of my favorite characters in the entire show was Omni-Man. Omni-Man is Mark Grayson's father, and he is the most powerful superhero in the entire world. In this show, of course, you might expect him to be like a Superman-like persona, but believe me, at the end of episode 1, something happens that just flips the show around. And just the way they end it, and that adds an interesting perspective to Omni-Man's character, and that's what just glued me throughout. But despite that, it also has a lot of other things that I can completely appreciate about the show. It's an animated show that is refreshing to watch, especially because of the fact that it is a superhero show, and at a time where we feel that nothing new can be done in this genre, comes along this show and just shows that, you know, it's all about the execution. It's all about how you execute a story that we've seen billions of times before. That's all it takes to keep it fresh. I absolutely love this season. I'm going to give Invincible season 1 an A. On the entertainment scale, it's a 9.5 out of 10. This is undoubtedly one of the year's best shows. Let's quickly look at Marvel's What If. I was not able to make individual reviews for the episodes as they came out, so I'll be talking about the first 3 episodes in this video, and the later episodes I'll cover in next week's The Flash Flick Show. So the first episode is called What If Captain Carter Were the First Avenger. So essentially, What If is a show where you just take pivotal points in the Marvel Cinematic Universe and then they play out in a different way. What if that would have happened? You know, it makes sense. So this first episode was very underwhelming to me. I just expected a lot more from it. And one of the major reasons for it being underwhelming is because I think the pacing was very weird. Now it has to cover a large amount of time. Now, as we know, Steve Rogers, he becomes Captain America after the incident done by Howard Stark. But in this episode, it's actually Peggy Carter who becomes the Super Soldier, who takes the Super Soldier serum. It's an interesting idea, but I thought the execution of it, just the pace of it, was very, very fast. Like, it just goes... I mean, I have nothing against fast pace, but then it's just covering so much story into just 30 minutes. It feels like they're cramming it up, and there was nothing particularly interesting or different about this version of events that I felt like, oh my god, that's such an great alternate scenario. So kind of underwhelming to me, but still a decent episode, but nothing too great. The next episode, however, was What If T'Challa Was a Star-Lord. This was amazing. This was just a great, fun, exciting episode that just focuses on T'Challa's character. What if he was the one who was abducted by Yondu's spaceship instead of Peter Quill? So that was a very interesting premise. I thought they did a great job. And it was really sad to hear Chadwick Boseman's voice for the last time. But yeah, overall, this was just a fun and a nice addition to the show. The third episode is also an interesting one. What if the world lost its mightiest heroes. So in this one, you actually go before the Avengers Initiative was formed, and you see each superhero, that is Iron Man, you know, be it Thor or Hawkeye, you just see all of these characters, they're slowly being killed off by some mysterious person. The central mystery of this episode was very intriguing to me. I mean, who is the person who's killing all of these Avengers? It was a very interesting story within the What If universe. The ending, however, the reveals and the motivation behind that person killing all of these superheroes doesn't make that much sense, but I thought it was still a fun episode. It was still a really fun and entertaining episode. So that's my general views on the first three episodes of Marvel's What If. Let's move on. Let's talk about this new anime film called Demon Slayer Mugen Train. This is actually a continuation of the show Demon Slayer. You can check out my review for the entire Demon Slayer show here. I thought this movie was incredible. This was just an experience to watch. There were moments in this movie where I was having goosebumps all over my skin. Honestly, the entire final 30 minutes of this movie is honestly one of the best final moments of any anime film ever. I just had a ton of fun watching Mugen Train. It's exactly the kind of film I wanted it to be. It's filled with gorgeous and beautiful looking animation. Top-notch animation, I have to say. I mean, seriously, such great animation. Characters are extremely well written. You just have this really, really good pace to it. It just keeps moving from start to finish. I just love this movie. If you are a fan of anime, I just love this movie. If you're a fan of anime, if you are a fan of the show, do not hesitate. Do not hesitate to watch this movie. It's brilliant. I'm going to give Mugen Train an A. On the entertainment scale, it's a 9.5 out of 10. This just blew me away. Let's just talk about the final season of Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Brooklyn Nine-Nine is honestly one of my favorite shows. And if you have never watched Brooklyn Nine-Nine, I highly suggest that you watch it. And the final episode just aired a few days ago, and I have to tell you, it was really good. I was completely satisfied with the finale of this show. I mean, you just get a closure to every single character that just feels perfect. Now, Brooklyn Nine-Nine is a show that is never serious. Like, it's not a serious cop drama. It's essentially a cop comedy. You have all of this stuff like crime solving, detective stuff, but at the same time, it's also extremely funny, and the final season does maintain that. Although I have to say that if I would compare this with the other seasons, this season is unfortunately my least favorite because it wasn't that funny. I love the finale, but a few episodes before that weren't always that humorous, or always, they just didn't have the level of comedy that the other seven seasons had. So I was slightly underwhelmed by that, but the finale just redeems the entire show. The finale is just a great end to the entire show. They just pull off one final heist in the finale. It's just super fun to watch those heist episodes in Brooklyn Nine-Nine. They were always my favorite, and this finale just nails it with everything that it does. So looking back at the show, I think Brooklyn Nine-Nine is definitely a show that if you haven't watched it, I will 100% recommend that you watch it. I'm going to give the final season of Brooklyn Nine-Nine a B+. On the entertainment scale, it is an 8 out of 10. But finally, before leaving, I wanted to give you guys an interesting update about Christopher Nolan's next film. Director Christopher Nolan made films like Inception, the entire Dark Knight trilogy, Interstellar, Dunkirk. I mean, he's a great director and is one of my favorite directors of all time. So his upcoming film is going to be about the creation of the world's first atomic bomb by Dr. J. Robert Oppenheimer. So he was the person who invented the world's first atomic bomb. And so the film is going to focus on his character. It's going to focus on the events that led to this. It's set in a world war setting. Two things I'm absolutely loving here. It's based on a true story. Anything that's based on a true story, I'm already sold. And the second thing is that the World War setting of it, I think it's going to be very interesting to see the process of creation of such a thing. And Nolan will always put in that unique twist and that unique vision of his into a film like this. And also there are rumors that Cillian Murphy might be playing Robert Oppenheimer. Cillian Murphy is a great actor, absolutely love him. So I think he's going to be a really good choice for playing Robert Oppenheimer. I'm very, very interested and intrigued by this film. So yeah, we'll see how all of it turns out. So that was the episode, guys. What did you think about this episode of the Flash Flick Show? Comment down below. Also tell me what other movies or shows do you want me to talk about in the next episode of the Flash Flick Show. Comment all of that down in the comments. Hit that like button if you enjoyed this video. Also make sure to subscribe so that you don't miss out on any new videos from this channel. And I'll see you again.